slacking now.
You said it was dark, but blimey! Not even me old bandit blinkers can cut through the murk in here.
If only I'd brought my latest invention. I just fixed it so it could get right inside the eyes and...
Get inside the eyeballs? Crikey! I ain't half glad you forgot whatever it was.
Drag the entire village out of bed to look for me. Poor things. Elimelech, we'd better get home before he has an heart attack.
Hey!
You two came here from the same town, right? Have you known each other for a long time?
Action Man!
Not really. We're friends, but we haven't known each other for long at all.
Only a few days, in fact.
But Bond, you enjoy is so much firm. I am certain you have chance of protracted standing.
Go on.
I can understand why. I felt close to being here since the very first moment we met. But not as close as some. There's a certain person she's very close to indeed. Isn't there?
I suppose.
By me.
Dad! Dad, are you there? He's not here. Come on, let's look somewhere else.
You can do it!
brought this on yourselves!
Just lost somewhere, or lost in their own town. Don't be blooming ridiculous. Yeah, maybe, eh?
Dad, are you there?
One place suits me just fine. I was getting tired of chasing them around everywhere.
Go on, my son. Here goes nothing. Axes of evil.
Just
Good. That's that one wrapped up.
Welcome, child. Let us pray.
Okay,
It looks like we'll be safe from monsters in here.
Aye.
Oh, hello. What's wrong with you two? You look terrified.
You look.
Come on now. There's no need to be afeard. We ain't monsters.
You must have been so worried. Well, don't fret. Your daughter's safe now.
Wait. Huh? Of course. Behind us.
Remember our strategy. A silent ambush from the rear. A shrewd strategy indeed.
Now's not the time to be complimenting its tactics. You two, get to safety.
We must regroup.
Yes, right away. Foreman, can you stand?
I live. Come on, lad.
Yes, Mr. Foreman, sir. Please, you have to breathe. Breathe!
Thank you.
sir. Please, you have to breathe. Breathe!
Saw their every move.
Looks like that really is the last of the monsters this time.
Mm. Now, go to your special one, sweet Beryl.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you so, so much.
Gorrick, it's good to see you at the best of times. But at the head of a rescue party, and with my daughter in tow... Well, I can't thank you enough.
Come now, I was simply doing my kingly duty, old friend. Were it possible, I would have come sooner, but... Alas, our entire realm is under siege.
So it wasn't just our monsters who turned then. It was a whole lot of them. Things are worse than I thought.
Noble Foreman, as Lord of the Realm, it falls to me to discover the truth behind their misbehavior and to restore the monsters to their former selves. Now think carefully, friend. Know you of anything which might explain this beastly business?
There is a legend passed down by my people. It tells of a slumbering dragon, black as the night, sealed away in a deep, dark place. Deep in the dark heart of the world, the Black One lies, his wings are furled. The night he brings devours the light, fills hearts once pure with seething spite.
Our safety on his sleep depends, for with his waking comes the end. The sun will set on days of peace. Should e'er his slumber chance to cease.
Nara, how the heck did you know that?
It's from a book I used to read when I was a child. I was always fascinated by it. But I didn't even know I knew the words until now.
There are forces at work in this world. Forces we can never hope to understand. That's the same rhyme, all right. Word for ancient word.
Intriguing. The eruptions on the Isle of the Fault, the sudden change in monsterkind. Could all our recent troubles be related to this black dragon? And if so...
Then does that mean this dragon, that's supposed to have been left well alone, might actually be waking up?
Well, it's an old tale, as I say, so there's no knowing how much truth might be in it.
This is not the first I have heard of the Great Black Dragon. The recent changes in our realm could well be related to this ancient evil. We must find out the truth of this, friends, before it is too late.
Excuse me, Your Majesty. Bianca and I were wondering if you might allow us to accompany you.
Whatever is going on in this world, it isn't good. We can't just leave you to face it on your own. We want to help.
Are you sure, though? Didn't you say you had something urgent to be getting back to in your world? Someone special?
Yes. We do. But knowing of the peril your world faces... We cannot, in good conscience, ignore your plight.
Such purity, such nobility, such effortless grace! Praise heavens for true-hearted maidens! Come, we journey together!
Thank you, sire! And everyone else as well. I promise you, you won't regret this.
Hey!
in it.